This next clip, this is in the studio, and there's a founder of one of the very first exchanges.
David Grossman there. Well, Malcolm Pally is the chairman and co-founder of Coincilium, which invests in blockchain startups, was the world's first blockchain technology company to float on the stock market. And Dan McCrum from the Financial Times is a little bit more sceptical about the promise.
Oh, he's very sceptical.
So is Bitcoin a profound financial innovation or an easy route to, let's call it, funny money? Malcolm, I'm going to start with you. How much damage do you think that Jamie Dimon's words did when he called it a fraud? Or is it the actions of China that have really spooked people today?
I think it's a combination of both, probably. This market is, with these cryptocurrencies, is susceptible to emotion, more so than any other market, because it trades 24/7, and effectively anything you'd say that can spook the market does. Anything
that's
you say,
not good, is it? It's not good if it's even more susceptible to emotion than all the other markets that are already.
Is it good? I don't know. My disclaimer is that I invest in the technology. Mm. This is all a big distraction for me and for our company, because everyone's focusing on the price of Bitcoin and the price of the cryptocurrencies that are going up, going down, or they're going broke, when in reality, what we're seeing is the most phenomenal revolution in technology, which has been brought about, and it's underlying these
That's the important bit.
I don't fear for the technology at all, no. I think that anyone who gets involved in speculating...
But how do you use the technology if the currency is completely...
Well, it's the other way around. The technology is what drives the currency. It happens to work like money.
Do you agree with that, Dan? Are we concentrating on the wrong thing here? I mean, if we see the end of Bitcoin, is that just the beginning of something else?
No, I think I'm a bit of a skeptic on the technology as well. But you talked about emotion, and the emotion that really is driving Bitcoin and all of this technology investment in these silly tokens, these ICOs, is hope. This idea that somehow this technology is going to deliver all these wonderful, promised good things. And I think what people are starting to see now with China shutting down some of the exchanges, and I think what we will eventually see, as with all bubbles, is that, you know, that those hope is going to turn to dust. This bubble will pop.
You heard that phrase when they were described as unsophisticated investors. What does that say to you? Does it mean people who don't have to go through the big institutions, who don't have to be robbed blind by, you know, rates that banks are charging, or does it mean gullible people?
I think it means gullible people. In
so you
sense.
Agree with that, do you?
With
the people that are buying into these things are more gullible investors.
If you would have put, I can't completely recall the figures right now, but if you would have put a few pence into Bitcoin at the very beginning, you would have made a multiple of your money, and no one was even bothering about it then. Right now, if people are chasing it now, then yes, of course, I think they're gullible. I say that with the proviso that providing they don't know what they're doing, they're gullible. If they know what they're doing, then fine.
Is this the dot-com bubble of, you know, the early 90s? Is this just about to go?
This could be the time that it goes completely bust. As Jamie Dimon, sort of head of JP Morgan, said this week, you can't really predict whether it could jump up and double again. That's the nature of bubbles. But you can be fairly certain that at some point it will go pop. And this looks
and
like
happens,
it.
Happens. What happens if it pops then? I mean,
probably the same as what happened with the internet. A lot of the speculation goes out of it, and the survivors like the Amazons, the Ebays, and all the genuine opportunities are actually allowed to develop in a way that's outside of that speculation.
I mean, tell us what scale we're talking about. Do a lot of regular people...
I think we're at risk of overstating the importance of this.
Right.
I mean, the hype of Bitcoin is totally disproportionate to its size. If you add up all the Bitcoins, and if you could sell them for dollars, which I don't think you could, it would be worth about $60 billion. And that's quite a lot of money to come from nothing, from a bit of computer code. But really, it's one moderate-sized listed company. If it disappeared, I don't think the world would really notice.
Okay, so let's just assume, though, that what we're talking about now is not whether Bitcoin comes or goes, but whether this technology, this innovation about a currency that can circumnavigate institutions and governments still has a future. Do you think it does?
It's more than just a currency. It happens to act like money. So therefore, it's treated like money. But the blockchain technology that underlies that has some tremendous applications.
Like,
one example: a professional social network, which is on a distributed basis. People are tokenizing assets. There's there's a lot of
we
that.
We could have a Newsnight Bitcoin, a Newsnight coin.
If you wanted to, yes. I mean, getting into the coins and the token side, I think it's too early to have that debate.
You hear this a lot. I don't think there is any real working example of something in the real world being used on a regular basis attached to this blockchain technology.
A little bit earlier.
What you can do is you can create currency out of nothing, because that's ephemeral. It's just the software. But the bit which all the banks are throwing money at, which you're seeing lots of businesses like yours, is sort of on this promise that one day they can sort out all of the problems.
Right.
But there are some big inherent contradictions in this.
So Dan, a quick thought then. Do you think Martin will be the one laughing? You know, that he will be the one that puts his money where his mouth is, and actually he will, you know, people that support this technology in 10 years' time will be the ones on top of the market.
No, I think the thing to realise about the currency is this big contradiction. It's somehow going to make you loads of money because the price is going to go up and up and up. But at the same time, everyone is going to use it as something to buy and sell on a daily basis.
It will never actually catch on.
But it won't catch on.
No, we're looking at the... everyone's worried about what's going on with this highly emotive state, but regulation is the next thing that's going to come. These markets, or certainly the technology and the applications of those who are doing token offers, are going to be regulated. They're going to be ICOs are going to be treated like IPOs.
Then it's the end of what Bitcoin's meant to be, isn't it?
Well, Bitcoin will be a part of that ecosystem, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's the end of it.
Thank you both very much indeed. Thanks for coming in. Well, it has been an interesting day for real currencies as well as virtual ones. The pound rose against